and Gene Autry.
I'm back in the saddle again, out where a friend is a friend, where the longhorn cattle feed on the road. When it's roundup time in Texas and the bloom is on the same, how I long to be in Texas, back a-riding on the range. Just the smell of bacon frying when it's sizzling in the pan. Hear the breakfast horn in the early morn, drinking coffee from a can. Just a-riding, rocking, rolling, pounding leather all day long. Just a-sweating, swaying, swearing, listening to a cowhand song. How it beckons, and I reckon I would work for any wage. Just to be again, to be free again, when the bloom is on the stage.
When it's round up time in Texas, and the bloom is on the stage. Then along to be in Texas, back a riding on the range. Just the smell of bacon frying, when it's sizzling in the pan. Hear the breakfast horn in the early morn, drinking coffee from a can.
Just a riding, rocking, roping, pounding leather all day long. Just a sweating, swaying, swearing, listening to a cowhand song. How it beckons, and I reckon I would work for any wage. Just to be again, to be free again, when the bloom is on the stage. Well, thank you, folks. Many, many thanks. And now, neighbors, here's a mighty pretty old tune that sparked many a young romance way back when we had our last Republican president. Remember? Carolina moon, keep shining, shining on the one who waits for me. Carolina moon, I'm pining, pining for the place I long to be. How I'm hoping tonight you'll go to the right window, gather your light, say I'm all right, please do. Tell her that I'm blue and lonely, dreamy Carolina moon.
Well, thank you, neighbors. Thanks a lot.
Hey, Gene.
Yeah?
Guess what?
What?
We now have a brand new cook in the kitchen.
We now have a new what?
Oh, jiggers. Here she comes now.
Jukebox pie and apple pan. Dowdy, make your eyes bug out and your tummy say, howdy, Mr. Artery.
Don't tell me you're the...
Yes, sir. Shake hands with your new culinary cut-up of the ham hocks and turnip greens.
Now, I've heard everything, Bud.
Careful, a little pre-dinner snack.
Hey, what in the world have you got there, Buttram?
For your information, these are called hors d'oeuvres.
Looks just like a plain sandwich to me.
Yeah, me too, Johnny. What kind are they, Patrick?
Well, I'll tell you. They're part caviar and part bologna.
What part's the bologna? I know I shouldn't ask.
The part about the caviar.
Some cook you are.
You can say that again, Gene.
Well, you can laugh if you want to, wise guys, but just wait till next Thursday when you taste the Thanksgiving turkey that I'm fixing.
Oh? Well, now that sounds better. How'd you dress it?
Oh, nothing formal. Just tennis shoes, a bow tie, and a pair of slacks.
Very funny, Buttram. But not very. What else you having?
Potatoes.
Oh, no. Every night we have potatoes. Hash brown potatoes, french fried potatoes, baked potatoes, shoestring potatoes, nothing but potatoes, potatoes, potatoes.
Getting a little ham with them potatoes, ain't we? I know, but for Thanksgiving this year, I'm fixing something different. Potatoes a la mode.
Potatoes a la mode.
Yeah.
Now, what in the world is that?
That's a cold potato on top of a hot potato. Seriously, though, Mr. Autry, today being just 5 days before Thanksgiving, I want to take advantage of this golden opportunity by telling you how much our warm, everlasting association means to me. In fact, you won't believe it, but just listen. Is you ever in a jam? Here I am.
I hope not.
And if you ever in a mess, S-O-S.
And for Smiley.
No. If they ever put a bullet through your brain, I'll complain.
It's friendship, friendship. Just a perfect friendship.
When other friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot. La da 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 dig dig dig.
Your time.
When alimony's got you flat, pass the hat. When bill collectors talk to phone, float alone if you can. But if you ever get a 10, you're free to spend. I'm your friend.
Friendship.
Friendship. Just a perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgot,
ours will still be hot. We'll still be friends.
That's what you think. Sue, your hair is red, your eyes are blue. I'd swap my horse and dog for you. Sue, City Sue. There ain't no gal as true as my sweet Sue, City Sue. I drove a herd of cattle down from old Nebraska way. That's how I come to be in the state of Iowa. I met a gal in Iowa. Her eyes were big and blue. I asked her what her name was. She said, Sioux City Sue. Sioux City Sue. Sioux City Sue. Your hair is red, your eyes are blue. I bought my horse and dog for you. Sioux City Sue. Sioux City Sue. There ain't no gal as true as my sweet Sioux City Sue. Hello?
Hello, Gene. Russ Bott.
Oh, hi, Russ. What's going on?
Has Carol left your place yet?
Carol? Why, she hasn't even been here.
What?
Why, no. Was she supposed to be?
Oh, I knew it. Something had happened to her. She left here at 5 o'clock to go over to your ranch to invite you to Thanksgiving dinner, and she's not back yet.
Now, Russ, just take it easy. She's probably stopped somewhere to visit some friends on the way. Tell you what, though, I'll be right over just in case. Hi, Russ. Heard anything yet?
I... Let's not go inside, Gene. Her mother doesn't know yet.
Know what?
Here, read this. I just found it stuck under the front door.
If you want your daughter returned safely, get together $5,000 in small bills. Then stay where you are and wait for further instructions.
What am I going to do, Gene?
The only thing you can do, Russ, get the money ready. Then wait like the note says to do. In the meantime, I'll ride into town and tell Sheriff Dillon what's happened.
Okay, Lefty. Put her down. Take the gag out of her mouth.
Yeah, right.
Why did you bring me up here? And who are you anyway?
Oh, now, take it easy, kid. Take it easy. We ain't gonna hate you. In fact, We're just playing a little game with your dad. Hey, we left him.
Yeah, sure, that's right. Yeah, that's all, kids. Just a little game, you understand?
Why didn't you tell me? I like him.
Hey, look, Louie, I'm scared. I ain't never snatched no kids before.
Shut up, knucklehead. I'm running the show.
All right.
You better do what he says, Mr. Knucklehead. Mr. Lewis seems to be in a bad mood today.
And now, look, kid.
Oh, my goodness. Why didn't I think of it before? Mr. Lewis probably just hungry, that's all.
What's being hungry got to do with it?
Oh, haven't you heard? People always get mad when they're hungry.
They do?
Oh, my, yes. Yeah? Say, I'll tell you what.
Yeah, what?
Let's open a can of beans.
Hey, yeah, that's a good idea. Is that okay with you, Louie?
Oh, sure. Why not? Go ahead. In fact, I'll even start a fire while you set the table. Mr. Knucklehead.
What time is it now, Gene?
9:15. Let me see that note again, will you, Sheriff?
Sure. Here. I've read it 1,000 times. And with the exception of those backward S's, it could be your handwriting for all I know.
You know, Jim, it's a funny thing, but I'd still swear I've seen S's and dollar signs made like that somewhere before. Not too long ago, either.
Sure, but where? That's the question.
Oh, I don't know. I guess it's probably just my imagination. By the way, what time does Dad's diner next door open up, you know?
10 o'clock, I think. Why?
Oh, I thought I'd take a little ride. Getting a cup of coffee and some breakfast. Maybe it'll help clear the cobwebs out of my brain.
We got a little business to talk over, huh?
Well, Mr. Louie, what about the story Mr. Knucklehead promised to tell me?
Hey, not now. Hey, kid, maybe later, huh?
But you promised.
Okay, all right. So I promise. What kind of story you want to hear?
Do you know Little Red Riding Hood?
Do I know who?
Little Red Riding Hood.
Sure you do, Mother Goose. Tell the kid the story.
Look, never mind the cracks, will you?
Tell the kid the story.
All right, huh? How's it start?
Once upon a time...
All right. Once upon a time, yeah. There was this here young tomato, you see, and... she was tagged with the moniker of Little Red Riding Hood, you understand? Howsoever, and consequently, one day, this little chick, she's hot-footing it through the woods, see, with a basket of grub for her grandmother. And this wolf, you know, this wolf gives it a double O, you see, and he decides to cop the victuals that the young chick is toting to the old dame, but now, what do you think happens?
I don't know, Mr. Knucklehead. What?
Yeah, what happened? What happened? The chick, you see, she outsmarts the wolf, and she turns him into the DA's office on a drummed-up booking line. And then she takes the grandma to the grub, and the wolf does life happily ever after.
Gosh, Mr. Knucklehead, you tell that story better than anyone I know.
Well, gee, I'm glad you liked it.
Oh, I did.
Yeah?
And now, Mr. Louie, do you suppose I could ask you a favor?
Well, yeah, it depends, kid. What is it?
Well, would it be too much trouble for you to take me home tonight?
What'd you say?
I said, would it be too much trouble for you to take me home tonight?
Yeah.
You see, tomorrow is Thanksgiving, and we're having a big turkey at my house. So I think I better be there.
Yeah, well, look, kid, I'm afraid you're going to have to skip Thanksgiving this year.
Skip Thanksgiving?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
But, Mr. Louie, nobody skips Thanksgiving. Why, it's my very favorite day of the whole year.
Wait, look, kid, will you? Oh, please, will you? Don't cry. Hey, kid, please, I can't stand to see you sad.
Hey, look, Lefty, come here. I was just thinking.
What?
Since we can't take the kid home, maybe we could...
Maybe
we could get a turkey and sort of celebrate here.
Hey, yeah, that's an idea. Good. Hey, how about that, honey?
What?
All right, it's a deal, then. You stay here with the kid, Louie. I'll slip into town right now and I'll buy us a turkey.
Well, morning, Gene. What you gonna have?
Morning, Dad. What do you recommend?
Oh, ham and eggs, bacon and eggs, hotcakes, waffles, anything you want. Here, take a look at the menu, see for yourself.
Thanks.
In town kind of early for you, ain't you? Especially seeing how it's...
Hey, hold it, Dad.
Now, what's the matter?
Did you write up this menu?
Why, yeah, I suppose I did. Leastwise... Hey, wait a minute. Come to think of it, I didn't do that one.
Who did, then?
Why, that there dishwasher I had working for me last week. Why, something wrong?
Never mind that now. What was the guy's name, do you remember?
Are you kidding? How should I know? He just come in looking for a job and he...
What's the matter?
Well, I'll be. Now, if that ain't a coincidence, there's the very same guy walking across the street right now.
Where?
That one. The one walking along with the turkey under his arm.
Well, sir, I took off from that lunch counter like a barn swallowed in a windstorm. Went next door and grabbed the sheriff. Then together, we followed our friend with the turkey clear up to almost the top of Black Bear Mountain. Finally, after about an hour, he stopped, got off his horse, and headed for a cabin hidden back among the trees. It was then 4:00 in the afternoon. So after talking it over, we decided to wait until it got dark before making our move. Okay, Jim. Let's go.
Right.
Now just keep down and be quiet as you can.
Gotcha. You lead the way.
Okay, Jim, hold it.
What do we do now?
Open the door as quiet as we can. If we rush them, they might do something to Carol. Got your gun ready?
Right.
Down to sleep.
Now I lay me down to sleep.
I pray the Lord my soul to keep.
I pray the Lord my soul to keep.
God bless Mommy and Daddy and all the living creatures in the whole wide world.
God bless Mommy and Daddy and all the living creatures in the whole wide world.
Amen.
Amen.
Good. Now we can all have... Uncle
Gene! Hey, what?
Don't reach either one of them.
You're covered.
I'll get their guns.
Golly, Uncle Gene, how did you know I was here?
Well, I'll tell you all about that later, honey. The important thing right now is that you're all right.
Well, of course I am. We've been having a wonderful time, haven't we, Mr. Knucklehead and Mr. Louie?
Oh, yeah, kid, sure. It's been swell.
Yeah, kid, just swell, yeah.
Oh, my, I almost forgot.
Forgot what, honey?
Now that we're not going to be up here tomorrow, Mr. Louie and Mr. Knucklehead can have Thanksgiving dinner at my house, just like I wanted.
What? Oh, about that. Look, kid, maybe next year, huh? You see, Lefty and me, we kind of forgot that the sheriff asked this place a long time ago.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But you will come next Thanksgiving, won't you?
Oh, you're darn right we will.
Oh, that's a promise.
Cross your heart?
Yeah, cross our hearts. Well, so long, kid. Now, take care of yourself.
That goes for me, too, Muppet. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, Mr. Louie and Mr. Knucklehead. I'll never forget
you. Folks, some of the most beautiful thoughts I've ever heard expressed have been in the form of music. As a case in point, take for instance this next song, which incidentally is our most sincere wish for each and every one of you. May the good Lord bless and keep you, whether near or far away. May you find that long-awaited golden day today. May your troubles all be small ones, and your fortune 10 times 10. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again.
May you walk with sunlight shining and the bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see.
Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows. Never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again.
May you walk with sunlight shining and the bluebird in every tree. May there be
never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again.
Until we're back in the saddle.